There are many things we don't understand about the universe, like what existed before the Big Bang, and if there is a higher power that created everything. Another mystery is why the Nutella bread always falls with the Nutella side down. These questions may not have easy answers, but some puzzles are simpler to solve than others. One thing scientists have discovered is that our Milky Way galaxy is being pulled towards a central point in the universe. This invisible force is causing not only our galaxy, but also other nearby galaxies to move towards it. Astronomers refer to this force as the Great Attractor. If it truly exists, it must be a massive object or a group of objects with a combined mass of about 10 quintillion solar masses. Finding this Great Attractor has been a real challenge for astronomers. It took them nearly 50 years to fully understand what was happening. In this video, I will explain how they approached this problem and what they ultimately discovered. Let's go! Laniakea description. Have you ever wondered how our cosmic neighbor is made? The answer lies in the Laniakea supercluster. It's this gigantic crew of galaxies in space. They named it after Hawaiian words that basically mean crazy huge heaven. And let me tell you, it lives up to its name. This thing stretches out for over 520 million light years, and it's got a bunch of galaxies, including our trusty Milky Way. So picture this. The Laniakea supercluster is like this massive neighborhood of galaxies, and right in the middle of it all is our galaxy, the Milky Way. It's like our home base in this cosmic city, surrounded by skyscraper-like galaxies. But here's where it gets really interesting. The Milky Way isn't just chilling there. It's actually doing this intricate dance with its neighboring galaxies. This dance is all thanks to gravity, the force that pulls things together. This cosmic ballet shapes the fate of galaxies, and it's been going on for ages. Gravity is like the maestro of this dance, making sure everyone hits their steps and moves in harmony. Now think of the Laniakea supercluster as a giant web of galaxies, all connected by gravity. It's like this intergalactic glue that holds everything together. And within this supercluster, you've got these groups of galaxies, kind of like families. They all started from the same cosmic roots and have grown together because of gravity's embrace. The Milky Way, for example, belongs to a gang called the Local Group, which includes the Andromeda Galaxy and the Triangle Galaxy. Galactic motion. Understanding the motion of galaxies within a cluster such as the Laniakea supercluster is a very hard but necessary task to be performed, because it can give us various insights on the nature of the part of the cosmos these galaxies are embedded in. In our specific case, understanding how galaxies move concerning the Milky Way and how the Milky Way itself moves in the universe is of paramount importance to better know our role in the cosmos. Studying the motion of galaxies within a cluster involves considering various components, including the one given by Hubble flow and the gravitational attraction exerted by galaxies on one another. Hubble is a very famous scientist who finally showed that indeed the universe was expanding. It is then easy to understand that the so-called Hubble flow describes the overall expansion of the universe. This expansion is isotropic, meaning it happens uniformly in all directions. In practice, galaxies are generally moving away from each other. Therefore, in a Hubble flow to which the whole universe is subjected, galaxies appear to recede from an observer in direct proportion to their distance. However, this only holds for galaxies that are very far from each other. If two or more galaxies are close, their gravitational attraction might overcome the Hubble flow and they will get closer instead of moving apart. In other words, within a galaxy cluster, the gravitational attraction between galaxies counteracts the overall expansion due to the Hubble flow. Last but not least, every galaxy has a peculiar motion component. This refers to the motion of galaxies within a cluster that is not solely due to the Hubble flow or gravitational attraction. It includes any additional, individual motions that galaxies might have. This peculiar motion can result from various factors, including interactions with neighboring galaxies, the influence of nearby massive objects, and the gravitational effects of dark matter. Now, the first problem astronomers had to face when it came to studying Laniakea is that this supercluster is not so dense to be bound by gravitational attraction, and we would expect it to move with the Hubble flow. In other words, based on observations, astronomers thought galaxies in this cluster were moving apart in all directions. However, they soon realized this was not observed. All the galaxies in the Laniakea supercluster were instead seen to move towards something. What that something was had to be determined. It took us more than 40 years, but we think we finally have an answer. If you want to know the explanation straight away, you can directly find it at the end of this video. But if you are an adventure lover, here's the story of how astronomers figured this out. The Great Attractor. What could it be? To start off, galaxies only move towards something they are attracted to, and no, we're not talking about something beautiful. It's not about physical attraction you feel when you are close to your crush. We're talking about gravitational attraction. Our Milky Way seemed to be on a road trip towards a specific region near the Hydra and Centaurus constellations. Here's how we discovered that. In the 1970s, astronomers created detailed maps of the cosmic microwave background of the universe and noticed that one side of the Milky Way was warmer than the other. This was a surprising find in an otherwise homogeneous universe. It was less than a 1/100th of a degree Fahrenheit difference, and yet it was enough to let us know that we were moving at 600 kilometers per second right towards the Centaurus constellation. This speed of 600 kilometers per second is precisely the Milky Way's peculiar velocity. It was like being lured by a cosmic magnet. But what could be causing this incredible speed? The idea was that maybe it was the Virgo cluster, a massive gathering of galaxies in the Virgo constellation. However, turns out it wasn't beefy enough to explain our speedy adventure. And here's where things get even wilder. As scientists mapped out the universe in the 1980s, they realized that it wasn't just us. A whole bunch of galaxies around us were also heading towards this mysterious Great Attractor. And it wasn't just some big object. It was estimated to be 10 quintillion times the mass of the Sun. That's like having thousands of colossal galaxies in one place. Now, they had to play cosmic detectives, armed with top-notch instruments and an insatiable curiosity. Astronomers turned their gaze towards Hydra and Centaurus, hoping to catch a glimpse of something grander, something that could hold the secret to this gravitational dance. But here's the cosmic catch. The Great Attractor was shrouded in a celestial no-man's land called the Zone of Avoidance. This is like trying to peek through a cosmic curtain made of dust and gas, especially in the Milky Way's equatorial plane. It's like trying to see through a foggy window. It's tough. The dust and gas make it a cosmic challenge, blocking our view of what lies beyond. So back in the 1970s and 80s, astronomers were playing a cosmic hide-and-seek. They couldn't find anything exciting, and it left them scratching their heads. Visible light wasn't the best way to peek through dust and gas clouds. This brought them to a cosmic realization. To unveil the secrets of the Great Attractor, they needed more than just telescopes. They needed ingenuity and cutting-edge tech. They had to employ fancy observatories, use smart data processing tricks, and look beyond the usual visible light into the realms of other wavelengths. The Great Attractor in X-rays. With the advancement in technology, astronomers were provided with new tools to unravel the mystery of the Great Attractor. They aimed their infrared telescopes toward the specific region of sky where the massive object was believed to be, hoping to detect any light emanating from it. However, their efforts were in vain as they found nothing beyond the obstructing clouds. Frustration loomed over them until a savior arrived in the form of the ROSAT mission. Launched on June 1, 1990, ROSAT was a game-changing space-based X-ray observatory that transformed our comprehension of the universe. Its primary objective was to meticulously study the X-ray sky like never before. The telescope accomplished this by conducting the first-ever all-sky survey in this wavelength region. By the way, ROSAT is the acronym of Röntgen Satellite, dedicated to Röntgen, the discoverer of X-rays. Not only did this satellite fulfill its mission by successfully identifying over 100,000 X-ray sources during the survey, but it also shattered the notion that there was nothing beyond the dust and gas clouds of our galaxy. By scrutinizing the sources in the region of interest, astronomers soon realized that a multitude of active galactic nuclei were emitting X-ray radiation. ROSAT ended its life in orbit with a mysterious failure. On April 25, 1998, a problem occurred with the star pointer that kept the satellite on its trajectory, which resulted in overheating. The problem was partially fixed, but operations were halved. On September 20th of the same year, an internal flywheel exceeded the maximum speed, causing the entire system to fail. At first, the problem was attributed to the difficulty of controlling the satellite in extreme conditions after the April troubles. But in 2008, after an in-depth analysis, the failure was attributed to a Russian cyber attack on the Goddard Space Center, which reached the company's computers, X-ray astrophysics section. Anyhow, further investigation led to the discovery that many of these sources found by ROSAT were part of a larger system known as the Norma Cluster. Named after the constellation Norma, in which it is located, this cluster plays a significant role in the motion of our galaxies. Despite the enormous mass of the Norma Cluster, however, it was not sufficient to account for the peculiar movement of the Milky Way and its neighboring galaxies. The puzzle remained unsolved, and astronomers were left pondering the missing pieces. Although the mystery remained incomplete, the data collected by ROSAT opened doors for further explanation and analysis, bringing humanity one step closer to solving the enigma of the Great Attractor. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The Shapely Attractor. So, just to recap, although the Norma Cluster is huge and local galaxies move towards it, it does not explain the full motion of local galaxies. The mass of the Great Attractor is not large enough to justify the attraction. When they looked at an even larger region of galaxies, however, astronomers found that the local galaxies and the Great Attractor were moving towards something even larger. It is known as the Shapely Supercluster. It contains more than 8,000 galaxies and has a mass of over 10 million billion suns. It is the most massive galaxy cluster within a billion light years, and we and every galaxy in our corner of the universe are moving toward it. The finding of Shapely's attractor made astronomers very happy. 44% of the Milky Way's motion is due to the Norma Cluster, closer to us, while the remaining 56% directly comes from galaxies in the Shapely's attractor. As you can see, as we hurtle through the cosmos, gravity shapes the path. Believe it or not, research on the Shapely Attractor continues to this day, as astronomers use advanced telescopes and observational techniques to study the properties and dynamics of this massive cosmic structure. If the Earth were a grain of sand, Shapely's Attractor would be like a colossal magnet buried beneath the beach, quietly pulling and influencing the motion of grains of sands for miles around, orchestrating a cosmic dance in the sandy expanse. However, some astronomers were not fully satisfied. They wanted more. Some of them thought that maybe something even bigger than the Norma Cluster and the Shapely Supercluster together could exist. They kept looking and looking until eventually they found it. And they named it the Vela Supercluster. It was found to lie in the Vela constellation, and astronomers are very good at giving names. Vela Supercluster. The researchers estimate that the Vela Supercluster is about the same mass as the Shapely Supercluster, of roughly 8,600 galaxies. The only difference is the distance from us, 650 million light-years for the Shapely Supercluster, and about 800 million light-years for Vela. Given that the typical galaxy has about 100 billion stars, researchers estimate that Vela could contain somewhere between 100 and 10,000 trillion stars. This incredible amount of stars embedded in each of the thousands of galaxies contained in Vela is moving farther and farther away from us at a speed of about 40 million miles per hour, or 18,000 kilometers per second. Despite that extra and rapidly increasing distance, however, Vela's influence can't be denied. The researchers estimate that Vela's gravitational tug on the local group of galaxies, which includes the Milky Way, has sped them up by about 110,000 miles per hour, or 50 kilometers per second. It may be hard to believe that such a huge object could go unnoticed for years and years, but it makes more sense when you consider that it is found in the zone of avoidance. As you can see, being an astronomer is not a walk in the park. Other theories. The Great Attractor is really an intriguing astronomical mystery. While most astronomers believe it to be a massive concentration of mass, potentially a supercluster of galaxies, that exerts a gravitational pull on surrounding galaxies, some alternative theories and phenomena have been proposed to explain its existence. One of these is the concept of dark flow. Dark flow is a term to use to describe a controversial observation made by scientists using data from the Wilkinson Microwave Anisotropy Probe, WMAP. The WMAP data indicated that galaxy clusters in one part of the sky were moving in a particular direction at a significant speed, independent of the overall expansion of the universe. This motion seemed to be in alignment with the general direction of the Great Attractor. The dark flow phenomenon was puzzling because it suggested the existence of some large-scale structure or force that was exerting influence on galaxy clusters beyond what could be explained by the known distribution of visible matter. Some scientists speculated that this could be evidence of a previously unknown region of the universe with a concentration of mass, potentially even something beyond the observable universe. However, it is important to note that the dark flow hypothesis has been met with skepticism and has not been universally accepted within the scientific community. Particularly, the discovery of the Vela supercluster made this theory even weaker, as we can now explain the Milky Way motion very accurately if we account for the Norma, Shapley, and Vela supercluster. Hello there! If you are in a rush to find out what the Great Attractor is and you skip to the end of this video, here's the scoop. It's not a single celestial body, but rather a gathering spot for all things cosmic, kind of like the bottom of a bowl. Astronomers now believe it consists of three groups of galaxies: the Norma cluster, the Shapley's supercluster, and the Vela supercluster. Combine these clusters weigh over 10 quintillion times the mass of the Sun. Pretty mind-blowing, right? The universe is full of mysteries, but with time and dedication, we can continue to unravel its secrets, one by one. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you think there might be more to the Great Attractor? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.